Good morning, my dear students. I hope you all are doing well. So, continuing with the last class, let's start today's class. So, today we will start a new poem from your general English course. All right. Since we completed the first chapter of our syllabus, that is The Portrait of a Lady by Khushwant Singh, and I hope you did understand the explanation part of that chapter well. All right, so moving to this poem, I would like to say few things here that whenever you go through a new chapter, you know, whenever you start a new chapter, always try to connect that poem or chapter with the previous chapter that we discussed. All right, now in this poem, that is A Photograph by Shirley Tolson. So since through the name itself, that is A Photograph, we come to know that there is a certain kind of picture, you know, there is a certain kind of image that is actually shown to us. All right, and the theme that the poetess draws here is the relationship between a mother and a daughter. All right, she shows the relationship that a mother and a daughter shares in their life. All right, since in the earlier chapter also we discussed the relationship between the grandmother and Khushwant Singh. All right, so similarly in this poem also we can see a human relationship, you know, a relationship which was very strong, a relationship with tends to be very strong between a mother and a daughter. All right, so this is one aspect of this poem. All right, the relationship between mother and daughter, this is one aspect of the poem. Now the another aspect of this poem that we will come to know, you know, while we go through the poem is that it also shows the permanency of nature and temporariness of human life. You know, human life is temporary. As human beings are mortal, we all know that human beings are what? Human beings are mortal. We will die one day. All right, so this theme that the poetess shows here in this poem, all right, that human life is temporary. All right, one day every person, if a person borns, then what happens? One day that person has to die. All right, and nature is what? Nature is permanent, it is eternal, it is everlasting. Nature just goes on and on, there is no end to it. All right, so this is what, you know, this poem tells us about. All right, so we can actually see two different aspects of our life in this poem. All right, we experience two different aspects of our life through this poem. Now let's go through the poem once. All right, then I shall explain the stanzas one by one. All right, if you have book with you, you please take out page number 11. That is A Photograph by Shirley Tolson. Now as you can see here, there is no information given about the poet, right, in this chapter. So there is no need to know much about the poet, because normally what happens that in the exams questions are not you know, they will not be asked about the poet. All right, so it will be enough if we just understand and go through the poem. So see, the cardboard shows me how it was when the two girl cousins went paddling, each one holding one of my mother's hands, and she, the big girl, some 12 years or so. All three stood still to smile through their hair at the uncle with the camera, a sweet face, my mother's, that was before I was born, and the sea, which appears to have changed less, washed their terribly transient feet. Some 20, 30 years later, she would laughed at the snapshot. "See, Betty and Dolly," she would say, "and look how they dressed us for the beach." The sea holiday was her past. Mine is her laughter. Both weary with the labored ease of loss. Now, she has been dead nearly as many years as that girl lived. And of this circumstance, there is nothing to say at all. It's silence silences. So beautiful poem. If you try to understand it through the words that, you know, it has been said and written in this poem, all right, it's again very touching, because the first chapter was also very touching because it's about human relationship. So whenever the story tells us about some kind of human relationships, you know, whenever it shows some kind of attachment and bonding, you know, that human beings share with each other, then that story definitely becomes very touching. All right, so here you have to remember, all right, some characters. So the first is definitely the poetess, all right, that is Shirley Tolston. So Shirley Tolston, that is the poetess, shares her relationship, her great bonding with her mother. All right, now in this whole poem, you will see that poetess's mother's childhood has been described. All right, it's not about the poetess's own childhood, but it describes the poetess's mother's childhood when she was a child back then. All right, then what were the things that she used to do, how she used to go around, you know, roam around with her cousins, all right, at the beach holiday, when they used to spend her you know, holidays at the beach. Then what were the things that they share, that do at that point of time? So these were the things that, you know, were being described in this poem. All right, so first of all, one thing that you need to remember here is that it's about poetess's mother's childhood that has been described. All right, please clear this out. It is not poetess's childhood, it's poetess's mother's childhood. Okay, now see, first line you see, "The cardboard shows me how it was." Now, what do you understand by this word, the cardboard? The cardboard here refers to the photograph. All right, it refers to the photograph of poetess's mother when she was a child back then. All right, and it has a frame of cardboard. It was not just simply lying, you know, the photograph was not just simply lying here and there, it was framed with a cardboard. All right, so that is what it says, the cardboard, all right, that consists of that photograph, shows me how it was. Shows me, that means the poetess says here, through the cardboard I get to get a certain kind of glance, all right, a certain kind of idea how my mother used to be when she was child in her childhood days. All right, that is the meaning of this first line. The cardboard shows me. Me here refers to the poet, that is Shirley Tolson. All right, it gives me an idea, it shows me how it was, how it was, how my mother used to be when she was a child. Next line you see, when the two girls' cousins went paddling. Two girl cousins. Now here, two girl cousins refer to the cousin sisters of poetess's mother. All right, not poets. The two girl cousins here refer to the poetess's mother's cousins. All right, so whenever they used to visit to some beach, you know, as spending their holiday days, then what they used to do? They used to paddle around the beach. They used to go around, right? And they used to walk through the water of the sea, holding each other's hand. All right? So that is what it says here. So in all, how many girls used to be there at that point of time when Poetess's mother was a child? That is three girls. All in all, three girls. That is Poetess's mother and her two girl cousins. All right? So in total, they were three. So when the two girl cousins went paddling, each one holding one of my mother's hands. Now there were two girl cousins. So how they used to walk? One of the girl cousins used to be on the right hand side and one girl cousin used to be on the left hand side. And they used to hold Poetess's mother's hand and they walked together, paddling around, you know, the water of the sea. Right, they used to roam around, they used to explore the beach, the sight of that beach, the beautiful scenery of the nature. All right, next, see, and she, the big girl. So among the three of them, the oldest, I won't say oldest, but the big girl was Poetess's mother. All right, and the other two girl cousins were in terms of age, they were younger than the Poetess's mother. Alright? So she, the big girl. Now she here refers to Poetess's mother. Alright? Shirley Tolson's mother. So she was the big girl among three of them, some 12 years or so. She was big, no doubt. But at that time, her age was of 12 years. Still, she was a child. Isn't it so? Because she was of 12 years. No doubt that she was the eldest. But 12 years, it's not that big girl also. Alright. So she was considered to be a child at that point of time. So some 12 years or so. All three stood still to smile through their hair at the uncle with the camera. So at that point of time, what they used to do is that they used to click pictures. They used to, you know, click images in order to capture that memory, in order to capture that moment, that particular moment that they used to share with each other. All right. And uncle was also there. Now uncle here refers to whose uncle? That is uncle of the poet. All right. So uncle used to click pictures of those, you know, three girls. And all the three girls, they used to stand still. They used to stand silently and they, you know, used to give different poses, all right, as the picture was on, as the camera was on, all right, as we girls also do. You know, whenever a camera comes up in front of us, we become very alert, we become very conscious. Why? Because we tend to look good in front of the camera, isn't it? We want to look good. We want to look attractive in front of the camera, and that is what they were also doing. All right, they became conscious, they became alert, you know, when uncle clicked their photo. So that is what it says here. All right, all three, that is all the three girls, they stood still. All right, they were standing in a very cautious manner, in a very alert manner. And they started to smile through their hair. Now their hairs were also like, you know, flying here and there, because at the sea, what happens? At sea, wind continuously keeps on blowing. All right. So through their hair only, all right, they were trying to smile in front of the camera and at the uncle with the camera. So the uncle who was holding the camera on his hand. Alright, so they were trying to give different poses. Next, see, a sweet face. Now, whose face is referred here as sweet? That is my mother's, Poetess's mother. So the poet, what did the poet say here? That my mother's face appeared to be very sweet. at that point of time when she was child back then. That was before I was born. Obviously, she was not married at because she was child itself. Isn't it? At that point of time, Poetess's mother was a child. She was just 12 years or so. So at that point of time, Shirley Tolson, the poet, was not born. Alright? Because her mother was it itself child. You know, her mother herself was child. So how could she be able to be in this world? Alright? So that is what it says, that a sweet face, that is my mother's, that was before I was born. So the face of my mother used to be very sweet at that point of time when she was child. And the time when I myself even did not, I was not born. And the sea, which appears to have changed less, washed their terribly transient feet. So, you know, the marks of their feet, you know, used to get hold in that water of the sea. You know, whenever they used to walk through the water of the sea, then the marks of their feet, you know, that tend to get attached in that water, in that sand of the sea, not water, all right, in that sand of the sea. So whenever the water comes, then what happens? That mark used to get washed away. All right, so that is what it says, that the sea, which appears to have changed less. Now the sea can never change. Why? Because as I already told you, that sea is a part of nature and nature is everlasting. All right, but the memories that they dropped at that point of time, that is the memory of that is having their feet marks, that is the marks of their feet. So that has been washed away. The memories were washed away. But sea, the water of the sea has never changed. Why? Because nature is eternal. Nature is permanent. And sea is a part of nature. Alright. But human life is temporary. So, in a symbolic way, we find, you know, the comparison that is being drawn between nature and human life. Alright, that is the symbolic meaning. That is the underlying meaning. But in the upper meaning, we see just, you know, a description of the poetess's mother's childhood, how they used to spend their days at that point of time when they used to visit to some sea beach during their holidays and all. Alright, so there are two kinds of meanings that are running through this whole poem. Alright, so please try to grasp into this. So this is the meaning of this first stanza. Alright, I hope this is clear to you all. So next stanzas we shall discuss in our next class. Alright, I hope this is clear to you. If you have got any doubt, you please ask me. Alright, your doubts will be cleared out. So for today, let's just stop our class here and see you in the next class. Alright, thank you very much.